That MRI, that was quite an experience. No idea I'd have to hold still for so long, you know.
You did great.
So tell me, what's the diagnosis? Do I just take a couple ibuprofen and call you in the morning, huh?
You know, I think before we go over all this, I'd like to call Scott. Is that okay?
Why do you want to do that, Tony?
I just thought it'd be nice if you could be here with him and you could hear the news together.
We're not talking just stress headaches, are we?
No.
No. You know, I think it'd be better if I just hear this by myself.
So you remember the CAT scan that I ran, and I said I thought I saw a spot on your brain, and that was causing your headaches?
Yeah, and that's why you wanted to do this test today, so you could take a better look.
Right. The MRI is the most sensitive diagnostic tool we have.
So what did you find out?
It's a melanoma. It's a growth on your brain. And it's malignant.
It's just right now I have to figure out what I'm going to do with this, with this growth. What sort of treatment are we taking? I mean, are we talking surgery? Or is it radiation? I mean, if it's radiation, do you think I'll lose my hair? Oh, God. Oh, God.
Let me call Scott.
No! Don't worry. I know you think I'm going to fall apart. It's the shock. I'm not going to fall apart.
I know you're not. But you do need some support right now because this is not going to be easy.
Tony, would you do me a favor? I need to know everything. I want you to explain it to me, and keep explaining it to me.
Okay.
I have to understand.
Okay, all right. That makes sense. So, the growth of the tumor that you have is actually several lesions.
Lesions?
Yeah, that's tumors that vary in size. So the MRI showed that these lesions go deep into the brain, and some of them are quite large, and that's the reason that you've had the severe headaches.
Okay. I see.
And so when I saw the results of the MRI, I did another procedure, and that showed the malignancy. Is that clear?
Yeah. That's fine. So, why don't you tell me about the treatments? I mean, is the treatment going to be surgery?
No, it's inoperable.
Why is it inoperable?
The lesions, the tumor, has embedded itself into the tissue of the brain. And so if we operate, that means that we have to cut out that tissue, which means that we do more harm than we do good.
And wait a minute, though. I mean, I thought that brain tissue could restore itself. I mean, you hear cases all the time, Tony, where people have one side of their brain injured, but then the other side will pick up and do the functions. I mean, that could happen to me. I mean, that could happen in time, couldn't it? Couldn't it?
No. It couldn't.
But if I wanted to go ahead with this operation, I could. I could take the risk.
Yeah.
So what would happen afterwards?
Well, you'd have some severe neurological deficiencies.
Such as?
You know, you're going to be paralyzed, unable to speak, unable to understand what people say to you.
You don't need to tell me anymore, Tommy. I've heard enough. You know, this is just so hard to accept. And I don't even feel sick. I'm sympathetic.
I know.
Tony, all that stuff you told me about, is that going to happen anyway? I mean, are these things going to continue to grow inside me year after year until I'm really a nothing?
No. Let me tell you something. You will it's crazy. You will never be. Listen.
Tony.
You will never be a nothing. Diseases. We're silly, you know? Listen, diseases will take like a part out of you. But it doesn't change you. It doesn't change Dominique. You remain Dominique.
Get it, Dominique.
Okay. Tell me.
Emma, am I gonna die?
Yeah. But, you know, there's nothing that you could have done about it because the tumor was already long progressed before you had any symptoms. So there's no blame.
So, just tell me, how long do I have?
I don't know that.
Can you give me a guess?
6 months or less, you know, there's some treatments that you could do. They have some side effects, and I think you need to discuss them with Scott. So if you want me to talk to the both of you together, or I can talk to him alone, whatever.
I think that it would be best if I tell Scott when time's right. But you've got to promise me that you are not going to tell anyone about this right now. Not even Bobby. Okay?
Got it.
I mean, I will tell Scott. I just have to find a way to do it.
Do you want to use my office for a minute?
I think that I have had just about enough of hospitals for one day, and I need to get some fresh air, okay? I'll call you.
Don't move,
Dominique.
I dropped my earring, and you're just about to step on it, I think.
Your earring?
Yeah. I didn't mean to make you jump, but I've really got to find it.
I can help you look.
Okay, it looks kind of like...
You okay? Yeah. No, really, I'm fine. Don't worry about it. Let's find your earring.
Well, it looks like this one. I'd just die if I lost it.
Well, then we'll just have to find it, won't we?
Yeah, I know I'm overreacting, but my sister gave it to me, and you know how those kind of things are.
Wait a minute. Is this it?
Thank you. You know what it's like to have something you can't live without?
Yeah. Definitely no.
I see. I gotta get going here soon.
Can't stay? Don't you want some banana bread?
Yeah, come on, it's a baker fun.
Oh, well.
Hey, Robin, could you hand me that pan, please?
Yeah.
Chet, we've been making banana bread all day long. Maxie was working with me, too, but she just now took a nap. My old family recipe. Know what I mean?
This is not just a social call, is it?
Yeah, I went to court.
And?
Appeal was turned down.
It's nice of you to come by and give us the news in person.
Well, I wish I could have gotten you off.
I'll look out with you.
Where are you headed?
School. One more class.
Oh, okay. I'll walk you there.
Scotty, wait. It's for you and Dominique.
Thank you. So long, Mac.
A lot of soup left. Guess you could freeze it and have it on another day if you like.
You know, why don't you take a break from all this?
Well, this is exactly what I want to do. I just want to hang around here with you and Maxie and Robin.
All right. But I want to take you out someplace special tonight.
I just want to stay home tonight. Just want to have dinner right in here. I want to tell Maxie some stories. I just want to spend time with all of us all together here.
All right. If that's what you want to do, sounds good enough to me. As long as I get to cook, though, I'm going to make my special pasta veggie Magnifico.
Okay, you're on.
And keep the banana bread coming. It's all for good.
Glad you like it. Going to have a lot to freeze. Oh my, it's getting late. Bobby's gonna come over in just a few minutes. I've got a mess I've gotta clean up.
Bobby's coming over?
Yeah, she's gonna help me take everything over to the brownstone. Am I gonna say bye to Maxie? I don't know what I did with those lists. Did you know what I did with them?
I'll see if I can help you find them.
Thank you. I probably overdid it with the lists, but I thought maybe you would want to know.
Don't you worry. I will follow it to the letter.
I know you will. These pajamas, they're a little bit short in the arms. I'm actually starting to grow out of them. Just didn't have the chance to go out and buy her some new ones. She's going to grow up so fast. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
The worst part is I won't be able to be there to watch her grow up.
Hey, you are definitely going to be a part of Maxie's life.
We'll both see to that.
And we are not going to make a single decision about anything unless we talk to you first.
I love you guys so much.
We love you too, honey.
Don't forget it, Felicia. Here you go.
Thank you for understanding. Well, I guess this is ready to pack up.
Listen, I'll call you this evening.
Okay.
And, if you think of anything, you call me, okay?
I will.
Hey, let me help you with those.
No, it's okay, Max. It's all right. They're light. I can match.
They are light.
I wish you didn't have to go through all this pain. I wish we'd make it go away somehow.
It wouldn't be so hard if it was just me. But how am I going to explain this separation to Maxie?
We should have gotten out of town, like I said, in the first place.
Oh, now we both agreed that was the wrong thing to do.
Yeah, I know, but you wouldn't be going through all this pain.
So little time. I'm gonna have to explain the separation to her.
You don't have to do it alone.
If she's up from her nap, I'm gonna go do it now.
All right, I'll be right here.
That your great-grandmother taught me when I was your age. Whenever she would go away, she would draw me a circle just like this. It's called a love circle. And she would hang it up in my room so I could look at it, and I would know that I was never, ever, ever alone. And look over here. Who's this? Right here in the middle, Maxie.
Max.
That's right. That's Maxie with a big heart. And look who's over here. There's Mommy. Mommy's the closest because Mommy loves you very much.
Love you, Mommy.
I love you. And all these other people love you, too. And they're going to look out for you. They're going to keep you safe because I have to go away. Look at me, sweetheart. I have to go away, and I don't know how long I'm going to be. And all these people are going to look out for you. Because they love you, too. And I love you.
I love you, Mom.
Give me a hug. Give me a big hug. Give me a hug. I love you, baby.